glaucoma coating. They had asked for bilateral different types and different stage codes each type, but highest stage correct. Thanks, Carolyn. The fact is that there is a specific rule for this. Now, let me just reiterate for some people what glaucoma is, because you kind of have to understand what it is to be able to code it correctly. Glaucoma is that sight-threatening disorder. It's marked by an increased intraocular pressure, or that's abbreviated IOP, and the pressure within the eye that is too high for the optic nerve to tolerate. But to be more specific, I've got a little diagram of what it does. But there's two types of glaucoma. There's several types of glaucoma, but there's two main types: open angle and closed angle. This is a closed angle view, and just to see the detail in this one, this was a really good shot, and I wanted to show it to you. But it's actually showing, the arrow is showing the pressure building up after the cornea. So if we go to the next one, it really, the next page has it. It's excellent because it shows you open and closed. So you do want to note, because remember with diabetes, and there's a default with you know, type 2 diabetes because more people have that. This doesn't have a default, but it's good to note that open angle glaucoma is accounts for 90% of all cases, because it's slow and it's a progressive disease, whereas closed angle is more of acute than an acute situation. It happens very quickly and it's very painful. But most people that have glaucoma, it's open angle. So what you're seeing there, the drainage, the open angle, see behind the cornea, between the cornea and the iris, all that fluid that is there, that is all pressurized. And if the fluid flow from the back of the eye or the inside of the eye and what is between the cornea and the iris isn't kept at an even balance, pressure builds up. But what happens with the pressure is that, you know, you think, well, okay, pressure. But remember that your eye is pressurized, and all the nerves and the blood vessels are so tiny in the eye that if you build up too much pressure, it squishes them. So let's scroll down to the next page, and they show you, I was able to actually show you, here's an example of normal vision and what people see when they start getting glaucoma. See how it circles and starts getting darker and darker, and you actually lose like that peripheral sight. So the progression of glaucoma, if you look at the optic nerve, see the optic nerve there, the red between the yellow lines, and it's nice and fat and juicy looking. Now, early damage, though, if you look at, see those lines going top to bottom, they're kind of straight, but in the second early stage one, that starts pressing on that optic nerve, that the muscles start bowing, and there's a little circle or pocket of fluid that starts to build up. And if you could see it, it's actually inflamed. See, the optic nerve starts getting inflamed. Then in the severe damage, that's what you see when you look in. But see how that optic nerve is pushed out of proportion, and there's a lot of pressure and fluid back there. Once you get into severe damage, there's nothing you can do. You lose your eyesight. So, you know, you want to, this is something you need to have checked, and lots of different things cause glaucoma, which is not something I could put in this slide because it really would take so long. So if we scroll down, let's talk about the differences in coding for glaucoma. Bilateral low-tension glaucoma, both moderate stages. Now, there's a difference between ICD-9 and ICD-10, so I wanted to bring this out because I found this information on a fantastic blog. And ICD-9, you've got low tension and moderate stage glaucoma. With glaucoma, you're going to usually have two codes. You're going to have the type of glaucoma and the stage. So we've got bilateral. Your choices are 365.12 low tension glaucoma, 365.12 0.72 moderate stage glaucoma. Now, in ICD-10, it actually, now that means both eyes, bilateral, because that's where we're talking laterality here. ICD-10, though, one code, H40.1232, low tension glaucoma, bilateral moderate stage. Now, and like we talked before, where, you know, it gives you more codes for specificity, this is one code that covers everything. Now, for example, let's say that the left eye has low tension glaucoma, mild stage, and the right eye has the same type but is moderate stage. ICD-9, how are we going to code that? 365.12, low tension glaucoma, 365.72, moderate stage glaucoma. But let's see what we do with ICD-10. Changes everything up, gives us laterality and granularity. ICD-10, a little more. There we go. Okay, now we have H401221, low tension glaucoma, left eye, mild stage. Then we have H401212, low tension glaucoma, right eye, moderate stage. See how much more specificity you get, and there's no need for the payer to say, well, we need some more information, you know, and you're going to have to send in more documentation. Now, the ICD-9-CM guidelines, it's very, we're still in ICD-9, so we need to talk about the guidelines, state for bilateral glaucoma, when each eye is a different stage, assign one code for the type and one code for the highest glaucoma stage. So, now we're saying, you can't get very specific because if you'll have one that's less, you're not able to tell the difference. And you're not even able to tell if it's left or right. So using ICD-9 for coding glaucoma lacks essential detail of the patient's condition. If we were looking for a patient improvement, we wouldn't even know we were dealing with an involvement of both eyes and that only one was mild stage. Of course, with the ICD-10, woo, wonderful thing, laterality, and the seventh character extensions for stages, there are many more code choices in the chapter. It makes sense in offering specific data of the patient's condition and status when data will be needed in the future for pay performance, other healthcare policies, and disease research. The numbers will be there to be crunched. And one more thing to make note of here, guys, is that you know, you with ICD-9, the reason that this question is even on a slide is because you don't know what to do. Now, with ICD-10, you don't have to worry about it. Because, see how specific it is? Less guesswork because it is very specific. Look, they got all the information for one the right eye, and they've got all the information for the left eye. No guessing about the guidelines and what do I do. You know, there's no confusion there. Very specific. And easy to code. You're going to love ICD-10. This is when you throw in the whoop whoop. Whoop whoop.
Whoop whoop. Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.